Com.
You know how to spell that? Oh, it'll be on the screen.
Yeah. Your spot was actually the very last half of that. The very last part of that where you said, see this,
yeah.
That's the spot.
Yeah.
The whole beginning was like
yeah.
a waste of time.
Okay, ready? One more time.
One more time, and just
from
be
where?
Very succinct. Start out, this is this, this is this.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can't go into the fish and the bear and the dog and the...
Until you tell us what that is.
Okay. This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. Now, what can these things do?
Start again.
This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. Now you may ask yourself, how do these affect our environment? Well, when you throw this out the window, or if you leave these laying around campus or school or wherever you may visit, they get trapped in our waterways. Therefore, the fish end up eating them, and the fish die.
The seal pick up. They get trapped in our waterways, and they eventually make it to the ocean, where the fish ingest it, and now we're killing our fish.
Okay. These end up making it to our waterways, and then slowly go to the ocean. And then in the ocean, the fish ingest it, which means we're slowly killing our fish. Then from there, the animals that feed on fish no longer have that source. So we are pretty much killing every animal in our environment because of these two things. These things are deadly not to only to us, but to the entire world around us.
One more time.
These things are not only deadly to us, but they're deadly to the entire world around us. To find out more how to save our planet, check out MaratasForestShouldNotDie.com.
One more time.
Rainforest.
Rainforest. To find out more how to save our planet, check out MaratasRainforestShouldNotDie.com.
Good.
Can't talk today.
Yeah, you're still in love with yourself. Do you need more for like the talking head soundbite part of
well,
it? Or
he hasn't done it. I'm pretty sure he wants to do the whole part of here. You can give me those.
I can set it up.
Yeah. He wants you to talk about, first of all, how the UN is now not supporting the film. The other action items he's been talking about is the loss of species in the rainforest because we're kind of down, and so we don't have the things that can heal people from things,
yep.
diseases like leukemia.
Yeah, I'm actually going to focus a lot on that.
You're gonna
I did a lot of research.
I'll okay. touch on it, but I'm not going to
yeah,
focus
I'm
on it.
All right, so what's your favorite hot topic? Air?
Yeah, I mean...
Water. Focus on the water.
Focus on the water? Okay.
Yeah, because, I mean, you live in, you know, I live in California.
The drought.
They're saying, you know, everyone has to cut back on water. Well, here we have at our fingertips a
I mean,
global
the
solution, and we're cutting it down.
Yeah. I mean, the water drives from the rainforest because the clouds pick up the water from the trees.
Yeah. Well, and it's the world's largest producer of water.
Yeah.
Right. People don't know that fresh water...
That's why it's called the rainforest.
That's right. People don't know that water comes out of the rainforest, even though it's called
the
rainforest. The
rainforest, yeah. They think it's like ocean. Well, that's
right.
true.
Well,
so
yeah.
even that statement right there is
yeah.
a fun one.
Yeah.
People don't think,
yeah.
which will make them think.
True.
It's you psychologically telling them to think.
Okay.
So try that.
How many of you think that water comes out of rainforest? I mean, the name is rainforest. I mean, people don't think that water may come out of rainforests. They think, oh, it's going to come out of the ocean. Well, rainforests are the leading provider of water and rain that encompass our earth. I mean, I live in California, and I know that we don't get enough rain. I mean, we're in a drought. But if we chop down all the rainforests, which create the water and the rain, other states will also go into drought, and the entire world will, because there's not enough rain, and there won't be enough water to allow us to have that atmospheric pressure of water come down on us. I mean, we can't live without water. I mean, it's a basic fact. You can't live without food, and you can't live without water. So where will we get the water if we cut down all the rainforests?
question. Just say that last sentence again.
Okay. If we cut down all our rainforests, where are we going to get all our water?
Good.
How do you feel about the UN pulling out of the film?
How do I feel about the UN pulling their support out of the film?
Start again.
How do I feel about the UN pulling out their support from the film? I think it's incredibly fishy. I mean, we are exposing this nationwide and this worldwide problem, and they had our backs. And now when we're actually digging deep and undiscovering these problems and these truths behind all this, they all of a sudden pull their support from us. I think something else is going on there. I don't think that's...
Say that again.
Yeah. I don't think you can use the word fishy, personally.
Yeah. I can use fishy.
Because it's fishy. So think of the word you're going to use before you get there.
I would use the irony. You know, here's an organization that's dedicated to saving our planet who suddenly pulls their support on a film that is educating us to save our planet.
Right. Okay.
How does that make sense? And that you're not throwing any accusations.
Yeah.
You're just posing a question. Yeah.
And the figure of speech in your delivery would be to say, isn't that ironic?
Yeah.
Because you're putting an exclamation point on the irony of it.
Yeah. The UN pulling the support out of this project. I feel like it's ironic. I mean, a group set out to help the environment, to help change and help save our natural resources, are now pulling their support from a film that is trying to get that word out, is trying to get other people to realize this is what's going on. I just feel like it's insanely ironic that a group known for trying to support the rainforest and support natural resources pulled out on a film that is making it known to everybody what the truth and what the reality of our rainforests are.
Pose the question.
Wait, what question?
Why is the UN?
Yeah. Oh, why?
Why could that be?
Okay, yeah, got it.
What possible reason could they have for doing that?
Okay.
You have a flyaway on this slide. There you go. That's good.
So just pick it up from that, or?
Yeah, just ask it as an independent question.
Okay. Why is the UN removing their support from this film?
Ironic, isn't it? Say it all together.
Why is the UN removing their support from this film? Ironic, isn't it?
That's great.
What other hot points has he had?
We're talking about 2 degrees or 5 years. So if the overall temperature of the country, of the world, increases by 2 degrees globally, it's like, that's the, you know, pull the plug thing.
Yeah, I kind of know the truth of that,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, scientifically, it's massive. There would have to be massive changes to it.
I mean, I'm in a bio class, and literally, they'd have.
Me,
I mean, she's taking science right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, it would be the equivalent of like it'd be the equivalent of a gajillion. What's the word I'm looking for?
Jules?
No, a gajillion.
Like atomic blast.
Not atomic blast.
She told me.
Solar flares.
Solar flares.
It'd be like a gajillion solar flares.
To increase by 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's. Yeah.
I don't shoot the messenger.
I'm not. I'm just saying, I might not be the best one to ask that question to.
We want good facts.
Yeah.
What is happening to the number of species?
There you go. Joe, talk about the people who live there.
Yeah.
I don't think a lot of people know that.
Okay.
That's a good idea. How's it impacting them?
Well, there's actually.
But what's that? What's that group called?
I don't remember. Just say there's an indigenous tribe.
Okay. There's an indigenous tribe that lives in the Marathos rainforest. This tribe has been there for hundreds of thousands of years.
No, 3,000 years. Start
over. That was hundreds of thousands. 3,000. Is it
3,000?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there's other tribes that have been there, though, that we've been researching so much that it's just like everything runs together. There's this indigenous tribe that lives in the Marathos rainforest. This specific tribe has been there for 3,000 years. They immigrated over from Asia, and what they've been doing is they rotate. They plant their crops and they rotate so they don't pose an effect and they don't pose a problem on the rainforest itself. They live there for 3,000 years and they haven't caused an issue. But now by them deforesting that area, this tribe is almost going extinct. They're killing off the native homeland for this tribe. They're killing off the resources and the food and the medicine and the plants and the trees and the animals that they live on. How is that fair? That'd be like going to us and taking away our food source and killing us off. That's pretty much what these companies are doing to this one tribe in the Marathos rainforest.
Just as a soundbite over there, you say big business. is killing off these tribes.
And the endangered orangutan that's there.
Oh, yeah. Big businesses are killing off this indigenous tribe. And also, there's an endangered orangutan that lives in the Marathos rainforest.